In this video, I'm going to show you how to add a service and essentially build your privacy policy. Now, adding a service is at the core of the policy solution. So at this point, it's really important to just talk a little bit about what a service is. Now, services can fall into two categories: third-party services and services that are related to your own data collection. So third-party services would apply if you use anything like MailChimp, Google Analytics, Facebook or social widgets, AdSense, basically anything that interacts with user data that is managed by a third party. And now the other type of services that I mentioned would be services related to your own data collection. And that can be things like contact forms, for example. Now, if you don't really know what a service is, you can just click right here on this question mark and it'll also explain to you what a service is. Now we're just gonna click on add a service and this window pops up with all of the services. So as you can see, we have over 600 services, which is what makes the solution so powerful. Each service has been carefully crafted by our international legal team. And of course, following the strictest guidelines applicable. So if you look on the right here, you can actually see the most frequent services that our users use. So at the very top is the contact form service. We also have Facebook account, Facebook like. So we're just going to click on the Facebook like to add it. And you'll notice right away at the bottom, it says service added. Now let's try clicking on Facebook account. Now this one has some additional parameters. So if you click in here, it's gonna ask you exactly what type of data you're going to be collecting or interacting with using this Facebook widget. So one of the common ones would be contact email. So we'll just add that. If we want to add another, just click on the plus right here. And perhaps access to the friends list might be another one. So when we're done with that, we can just click on add, which also adds it to the bottom here. The service is added. Now let's say we want to add something like analytics, so an analytics service. We click on the left here on the category analytics and we start typing Google. So it comes up here pretty quickly and we can just click add and add that service. Now let's say we want to add a social widget like Pinterest. Now you'll notice that it doesn't show up. Now, this is actually one of the most common errors that some users have, which is not checking on the left side here to make sure that all categories are actually selected. Now that we've clicked all, you can see it comes up very easily here and we can just add that. Now another really useful tip here is if you don't really have a complete idea of what services you may or may not need, or you need some tips or something to give you a better idea of what to add, you can simply click on all, which will show you all 600 plus clauses that we currently have, and just sort of scroll through it, and it might actually help you to think of some things or services that you might have on your site that you may need to add. You'll also notice that some of these services are only available on pro accounts, while some others are available to free accounts. Now, if for some reason there's a service that you need that we do not have, you can feel free to send us a quick email or message and let us know, and we will try to include it in the future. Now, if you need that service immediately right away, or you have something that's very specialized and specific to your particular website or app, you can simply click on Create Custom Service, which is a feature that's only available to pro accounts. So it's not available to free accounts. And when you click on this, it's going to take you to our pre-built form. So filling this out is fairly easy. You simply put the name of your service. Here I'm putting my service. And here we'll add a description. Now it's important to be as descriptive as possible. You want to be sure to include what types of personal data you're collecting, the purpose of it, and something that might actually help you here is to take a look at the way some of our clauses are written. So I'm going to show you that in 1 minute, really quickly, how you can do that. For now, we're simply going to put in my service info and the website that it links to. Okay, so when we're done with that, we can simply scroll here, click on add, and of course it adds it here. So if we're done and we're satisfied with all of the services that we've added, we can just click on save and close, which takes us to this page, which if you look on the left here, you can see it has all of the services that we have currently on our policy, and it has all of the categories for each service. So that's quite useful. Now, if we look to our right here, you can see preview. And if we click on the preview, what we see is exactly how your policy looks to your users, to anyone that clicks on it. So this is the default iconized view, which is nice and convenient and elegantly segmented so that people can get a quick idea of the sort of information that you're collecting in an easy to understand way, as required under some legislations. So if you want to see the complete privacy policy with the full legal text, you can simply click here on show the complete privacy policy. But just before we do that, I'm just gonna look right here, further information about personal data. This is pretty important. This is where your custom clause is. So you will see all the information, again, related to your custom service right in this section, and the others are included up here. Now, if we click on show the complete privacy policy, we have the full legal text that is also conveniently and elegantly segmented so that it's still easy for users to understand and to read the information in your privacy policy. We also have these extendable sections here for the services, which when clicked on extends to show the information. So if you're writing your own custom clause, what you can do is save your policy while you're adding services, click preview, and have a quick read of how some of these third-party services are worded, and then you can edit your custom clause to make sure that you're also being as descriptive and including relevant information. We can just go ahead and scroll down, and below here we have definitions and legal references, which is also quite important because there are some terms that are a bit unique to the law. So it's important that users can also have a look and understand what is meant by some of these terms. So if you're satisfied with that, you can simply just close that off and then click on next.